Wow. And two of us, I think, went up in levels. I wonder how much damage the arrows are actually doing for all that we're picking them up. Another ring of wizardry. I don't think they stack, do they? A wand of magic missile. More thieves' tools. Leather armor. Gauntlets of fire giant strength. We need to really, like, identify this stuff because we already know what it is. I don't know if she needs to be holding the stuff that we identify. Improved identifier. Nothing new. Gauntlets of fire giant strength. I guess the Tagor, because he's got 17 strength. So AC minus 10. Hoo-hoo-hoo! Look at that. Strength 22. Armor class negative 8. Braces of protection plus 2. These are plus 5. What does she have? Just braces of protection. So I guess we'll give this to Delmere. He's negative 1 armor class. Negative 3. Ew. Well, that was a mighty battle for this stuff. I think we should save and rest. And then don't know why they felt that would be a good idea. Make that sound, it's like destroying my ears. I thought I clicked that. I clicked on the number. Next to it. So now what I just want to do is just get my spells back. Which is just resting. Spell expired, yes. So I'm going to save again. The nasty wood beast. Oh god, here we go. I was ready to start breaking out the spells. Yeah, but Umber Hulks don't disappear like that. into new areas? Looks like. Oh, here we go again. Say, I am having a degree of fun with us. Another cloak of protection. Don't need it. I'm saving after every battle with these things. Oh, 31. That's not good. I didn't notice he got hurt so quickly. Can I just... No. Break camp. I'm not convinced that she really heals him. I mean, maybe. Save. I don't know if anything interrupts your sleep. That's why I keep saving first and then resting. And then saving again. I'm still finding new areas. Alright, we can actually move that way. As you emerge from the forest into a small clearing, the ghostly form of a man appears from nowhere to confront you. Well, well, well. I see the defilers of the forest have finally come to carve out its heart. Tell me, why should I not wither you away to nothingness, as you have done to so many parts of my forest? We don't want trouble. We seek a way into the city. Petty fools. What do you think you can do against the evil in Myth Drannor? Better heroes than you have tried their skill at banishing the evil, and they have paid with their lives. I do know the way to the city, but I don't think you are quite worthy of that information. Maybe I should let my children just rip you limb from limb. Got some kind of ruins or something behind him. Maybe that's the place. Okay. We reply. Look, we don't see any need for confrontation. We do apologize for cutting down those trees, but for the greater good, we must reach the ruined city. If you really have been around for so long, why don't you share some of your lore? Perhaps with your knowledge and our might, we can restore the forest and Myth Drannor together. Grudgingly, the old man begins to speak. I suppose it would do little harm to tell you of the history of Myth Drannor. You're still going to carve us limb from limb or rip our limbs off or something? Once, long ago, Myth Drannor was an elven camp, a community of large inhabited trees, of clear springs and pools. Later, it became an elven city, a place of needle-sharp spires of growing, hollow wood, linked by treacherous suspension spans that were either railless wooden arches or precarious running ropes. Quote unquote. The city grew in size and might with the elven communities of the Western Dragon Reach, over some 2,000 years until humans first came to the north shores of the Sea of Fallen Stars. The king of the elves invited all the races, humans, elves, dwarves, halflings, and gnomes, to come and live in harmony. Together, they could build up the defenses of the city so that the goblin king races would not be a threat. Myth Drannor earned the name the Towers of Beauty among bards, and as the years passed and happiness reigned over all, the elves gave it the name the City of Love, in celebration of the peace and contentment enjoyed by all the races of Faerûn. Yet the gods grew restless, and all things changed under their hands. Greatness is always hurled down in the end. This font is a little hard to read. So it was with Myth Drannor, as with all great cities. The downfall of Myth Drannor began with the arrival of the creatures from the outer planes. They joined with the goblin races and overran Myth Drannor. The armies from the Shadow Realm were so numerous that for every 100 foes dispatched by the city's defenders, 1,000 more took their place. Evacuation of the city became necessary, and most of the inhabitants of the city escaped, thanks to the devotion of the defenders. One defender, in particular, Captain Flar, was especially heroic. He slew many of the Shadow Beasts with a sword that burned with a blue fire. Unfortunately for us, he fell that day, and we buried him with honors in the warrior's tomb. He will always be remembered by the children of those he saved. I, too, died on that fateful day, which is why you're translucent, partly transparent, whatever. But my love for this forest and Myth Drannor kept me alive in spirit. I will protect the forest until the end of time. Perhaps, if you are truly worthy, and you restore Myth Drannor, I will at last find my rest. Know that Myth Drannor and I are one, and that I alone dictate whether or not you reach the ruins. If you pass my test, I will show you the path to the ruins of our great city. We will gladly take your test, you reply. The test is a simple one. Have one member of your party choose one of my books to read. Choose carefully, for all of the books are beneficial, and all of the books are harmful. Choose wisely, and you will be rewarded. Choose poorly, and you will feel Myth Drannor's wrath. Choose one of my books. They're all beneficial, and they're all harmful. Choose wisely. Select a character who will read one of the sage's books. Press escape to cancel. What happens if we press escape to cancel? You wretched souls are truly unworthy. To spare your lives, I will not show you the way to the ruins. Goodbye. Well, we continue on that way, or we can just restore. Now, where were we? Now, the only problem is, the map doesn't go back to the way it was. It still shows where we've been. What if we answer this? What were you supposed to do? Ask the trees to leave? Lower life forms than you have learned to communicate with the trees that surround them. However, finding a lower life form than you around here would be a task. Well, we've seen quite a few. You who have killed my trees, and you have killed my trees, and that is something that is unforgivable. Just who do you think you are? I am the Lord Protector of this forest, and have been for longer than your families have walked this plain, and I am in no mood for your backtalk. Alright, so he tells us the lore. Okay. I will read it, since I have high intelligence. Which of the sage's books will Amethyst read? The Book of Adroit Deeds, Daring Deeds, Arcane Deeds, or Exalted Deeds? Well, since I am familiar with magic, maybe I should read Arcane Deeds. Amethyst attains level 12, gaining one hit point. One hit point, wow. You have chosen wisely, says the ancient sage. The path will be shown unto you. May fortune walk at your side, and don't cut down any more trees. Okay. Is this the way? I'm guessing that's the way. I don't want to go there just yet, because we still have that other area to get to. And I'm I'm continuing to chop down trees anyway. We've been that way. See if we can get anywhere new. That's new. Here we go. This is new. Some quick save here. Myth Drannor revealed. Oh. Hi. That easy? They're dying easily now. I'm just used to fighting those other things. Make that sound when we're getting hit or when we hit them. It looks like from the timing that's when they hit us. Alright, that bird was messed up. So we don't have moderate wounds? Or did I just missed it when we're memorizing spells. Okay. That's when I finished this area. Oh, we've got here. More arrows for our friend. And more food. A lot of food. All right. We act like we can't create food or something. Where are we? Okay. That's a unbreakable tree. Choppable. Oh, I see you. This time I actually saw you before I heard you. Oh, you didn't touch us at all. So how many arrows does he have now? 53? I don't think we've ever had that many arrows in Eye of the Beholder game. I would not want to play this without a map, sorry. Didn't imagine mapping this crap out. Especially in a game like this where things can just come after you. And plus you don't, you know, some trees don't give a clear indication of what can be chopped down and what can't. Especially that maze where you teleport around. Okay, I didn't realize that. Okay. So looking at the map, it doesn't look like there's too much more to be... I mean, this might be it. I could be wrong. But I could be right. So how do I get back to where I was? I need to go back this way. The stuff we dropped already? Another armor, yeah. Wait a second, we can go that way? We can go... that way. I'm sorry, where we came from. There's no other way out of here unless that goes up, though. I'm in hell. Hate stuff like this. Damn it, how do I get back to where I was? I keep going in circles. I keep ending up back here. I want to find my way back. That's going back. Oh, I actually uncovered a new area. A new square was right there. I think. That's new. So though we're lost, we're finding new areas. Maybe we have to do... maybe we have to go that way. I thought I could get there from where we were, like, wandering around just then. Oh. What'd I do? hit ourselves. We attacked ourselves or something. Okay, so this is Myth Drannor. I wonder if these monsters respawn or they're permanent. There's all the other games like this, Dungeon Master, Eye of the Beholder. For the most part, the monsters do not respawn. This is a big dead end, actually. Let's go this way. Because this goes off the map and we'll... It's quite a long way. And we'll have to find our way back again. Okay, we're here. This goes through... Okay. Oh. We have not been here? Wow. Okay, so we got arrow plus two here. You know, I should go through everything and just get rid of the regular arrows. Chainmail. A bow. And a long sword. Okay. So we would have missed this if we hadn't gotten lost, but I don't. I'm still lost. That's the thing. Can I go through? Okay. I know we have to get do some teleporting forest areas just to get back. So find my way to that area and then navigate through it. Which might be through here. Okay. I think might be the right way. Because I know at the end of this you can teleport. You can go through that. Which is right up here. There's all the crap I dropped. Wait. Oh, this is what... Oh, yeah. It reappears afterwards? Alright. Yeah, I know you gotta go past this area. So. Alright. Now, do I go this way or go here? Wasn't I just here? All right, maybe we do go this way? Wait. Yeah, okay. Did it? We're back here. Did it undo itself? Hold on. Gonna save. And then. Or, hold on a second. How do I get back into search mode so I can search character? No, I don't want that. No, unexplore level? Oh, no. Explore level. Okay, good, because this is where we were. Okay, so this, for reference, this is the way back to Myth Drannor. This is the way to the heroes, the warriors, whatever. Which I actually step forward into and then did not explore, basically. I don't know what I'm doing. I have the feeling, did we explore the northwest area? Is that? I hope we don't have to chop down all the trees again. Those should be all. Those should be, like, all chopped down already. But I guess we missed some. Oh, unfortunately. We have him. Take that out of the effect. We just might not have been over here. Here with Tom, we're not going to chop down any more trees. And here we go, chopping down trees. So make sure I didn't miss anything. Because there might be one more secret. I'm not sure. Is this all the stuff I dropped? Yeah. So I've been up in here then. Up in here, up in here. So I wonder if his demeanor towards you turns more. Oh, that's real. If you chop down less trees, if he's less angry. Just want to take a quick look up here. Oops, I'm turning. I thought I was pressing forward. I guess we've seen it all. We've done it all, baby! Shut up, bird. Damn trees. That one's invulnerable. Making your way through the forest, you come upon a great tomb consecrated to the fallen warriors of Myth Drannor. Ancient boughs high above cast shadows everywhere, which shift and darken in the grip of a sudden icy wind. Do you wish to enter the mausoleum? No. Next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.